Hi all. In continuation with the earlier session where we discussed about the debugging and the uploading of the firmware into the target board with the help of on-chip circuitry in system programming and in application programming, we can load the firmware development ID into the system. Now we'll go into a bit more detail. Embedded system environment, where we'll discuss about the bit more detail about IDE, integrated development environments, nothing but what firmware you are going to use it to develop or debug or to develop that firmware. And what is the role of IDE? It can able to disassemble it, decompile it. Then some about simulator. It is nothing but in circuit simulator, emulator also are available. Simulator, it is like IDE only, emulator to debug hardware. We can use different debug also, it's not emulator always, you need to use it. Then technique, some tools are used to debug the hardware and software. More number of tools for hardware. For software, we can use any IDE or any simulator is sufficient. Then few of the tools are used for hardware debugging, that is magnifying glass, multimeter, CRO, logic controllers are used. Then that techniques also used in boundary scanning also, whether all the complex circuitry, if you are working with a complex target board, so we need to scan each pin, what the voltage is, or what waveform you are getting it. What the input voltage given, what exact output required output you are getting or not, that we can do with the boundary scanning. Okay. Now here already many various techniques are used, or various tools are there for design and development of the embedded system. Okay. But how we can use properly for debugging? Okay. Now this is what typical diagram shows, that the development environment, what are things are included in that? In that the target PC, of course, then the PCB fabrication, printed circuit board fabrication is required, because most embedded system uses PCB. Then there is serial communication between the emulator, if you want to debug this target board, emulator is used. Then host machine come up with EDA tool and IDE. Okay, we'll discuss more detail about IDE and EDA tool in the upcoming parts. Then through JTAG, we can debug the hardware or target board. We can use signal generator to provide the signals, to external signals to the target board. Okay, this we can observe the waveform, to observe any waveform or voltage level, that can be achieved with the CRO or logic analyzer or multimeter to measure any voltage or current circuit. Okay. So these are tools are used to debug it. Now EDA, already you know that IDE is integrated development environment, like Kyle compiler, it can have an editor, debugger, we can analyze the internal register content. Now what is that EDE? This is electronic design automation tool. Okay, the EDA tool is basically like a development of PCB board, PCB layout. So that EDA tool are more widely used. Okay, now this can be EDA tool we can do with the help of some programming language like VHDL is widely used to develop any automation tool. Okay, nothing but it is one kind of tool for only for hardware point of view. This also basically usually supplied by the vendors, each vendor having its own EDA tool, or some EDA tool having all the functionality of other vendors also. Okay. The now come to the emulate hardware during debugging. So more widely use some signal source, CRO, multimeter. That is because of hardware can understand voltage levels, or we can observe the waveforms. So we need some function generator where external signals we can view and analyze the output. Now in case of IDE, IDE, as I said, that which includes some text editor, not only editor, linker, debugger, cross compiler, the many various tools are available. These are like one kind of GUI based, it's not command based IDE. Command based IDE example is your normal Turbo C IDE. GUI based IDE is like Visual, C++, or for your in your lab you are using it Kyle IDE. Okay, well, more user interactive are there. There are many IDE are there specific to the specific controller or processor, but more widely use Kyle IDE because it supports almost n number of almost all vendors. It will support it where you can choose the select the target controller or processor also, okay, to program that processor or controller. Disassembler and decompiler. Okay, disassembler nothing but convert your machine code into assembly, exactly next further level, high level. The decompiler translate your machine code into high level language. Okay, disassembler name itself say that the machine code to the assembly. Decompiler basically used for the high level language, machine code to the high level. So these two things are included in the IDE. Nothing but IDE supports both assembly language also and the high level languages. Okay. It depends on what controller you are working on it, whether that controller supports assembly programming also or high level programming also. It depends on the controller and that IDE or who is the vendor of it. Now come to the, because more concentration on debugging now. This includes the simulator, emulator and debugging. Emulator is a software tool which acts like a controller, it acts like that hard, that target device. Emulator nothing but on a hardware device which emulates the functionality of the target. It is also acts like a the target device or that board or processor. Emulator is nothing but software, emulator means nothing but hardware. Emulator where hardware act, the software acts like a hardware, emulator the hardware acts like a hardware itself. Okay. Now you will think of that hardware acts like the hardware, then why need additional hardware? This is additional hardware, we can do it customization, we can add, remove, disconnect, we can do it. Customization option, but in case of target board does not have any customize option if you are deploying it any if you are designing any applications. Nothing but debugging, you will need to think in both way, hardware and point of view and software point of view. Okay. Ultimately you have to debug your firmware. Okay. That is the main target. So simulator purely a software, does not require real target system. That is the main problem here. A very primitive, nothing but restrictions are there, or some IO will support, some does not support it. The lack of real-time behavior we can't do it on simulator because your hardware acts, software acts as a hardware. So real-time behavior is not possible. That's why you go for the simulator. Now there are many advantage, disadvantage of each simulator and emulator also. Advantage of simulator is no need of original target board. So no need to purchase it, just to develop your firmware. Those who vendor has the target board, we can get tested also your program. Simulate IO peripherals. IO peripheral major problem. Now for example, you want to test some temperature sensor or camera or any other sensor you are working with, that is the major problem if you are working with the simulator. Okay. Then simulator comes in abnormal condition, it supports some desired value. We can, because hardware sometimes does not support abnormal condition, but that we can adopt in the simulator also, and we can account to that your hardware also we can change it. Okay. Now limitation or disadvantage, we can say that a deviation from real behavior, it does not behave like a real time, because the embedded system usually deployed in the real system, the how it behaves, because we are not working on software based with limited or we are not working on any host machine. Okay. that is main problem, lack of real time behavior can be, we need to analyze it. That is the major problem of simulator. That's why we will always, after developing the firmware with the help of simulator, dump into the or burn into the target board or target device. So we can real time behavior also we can analyze it. This limitation can be overcome from this. The limitation of this simulator can be overcome. Now emulator and debugging. Debugging, it's, as I said, that we can use for both firmware debugging or software or even hardware debugging also. Okay, nothing but in firmware debugging, or we can analyze the content of resistors, flow of sequence, content of memory, that we can analyze it. Okay, but what actually, how much, whether the voltage is reaching from one IC to another IC on target board, that is possible in the emulator. As I said, that debugging in two parts, two classes are there, hardware and firmware debugging. So the hardware debugging deal with monitoring the various bus signals, checking the status of line, or checking each wires running on that board also. That is hardware debugging. Firmware, nothing but content of resistor, content of memory, content of CPU, register content, or any flag bits changes or flow control. Okay, that we can observe with the debugger. Next one is we can use the on-chip debugging. Okay, this is now going into emulator part, on-chip. We are not in the any IDE or simulator. Now we are working on the target. So what some technique or types of debugging we can use: incremental EEPROM burning technique, inline breaking, inline breakpoint system you can adopt it, monitor based program you can use it, in-circuit emulator also you can use, on-chip firmware debugging also you can use it. Okay, so discuss it one by one. First start with the incremental. Now incremental electrical erasable programmable read only memory burning technique. In this technique, we need to find out the need to generate or all firmware and burn that firmware in the incremental order. So what is mean by incremental order? Now if the first functionality wise we need to burn it, now put that code into the right. Functionality wise also you can do it, or line by line also you can do it. So functionality is found working perfectly, no problem. So load that into the target board, then go for next function. If that is also correct, then in continuation with the previous function load it. Okay. The one by one, this is basically adopted when you are working with very complex firmware, the where n number of functions are there. So if you dumping complete your entire firmware into the target board, it is, and again later on debugging is more time consuming. If you debugging in at functional levels, each functional level, so easier. Only problem is that it get time consumed. Okay. That is the main problem here. Now we can use some breakpoints. We can put the breakpoints after certain any function or after certain numbers of, and we can analyze the content, or we can get the fetch the content of any content with the help of printf statements are used. Okay, here we can do entire program we can burn into the EEPROM of the any controller. So this is the next part, is that is a monitor program based firmware debugging. Now monitor program based debugging, nothing but then additional ROM is used, so which is nothing but external to the CPU. It's not inside the CPU. Okay. External to CPU. Okay. Now even RAM also is used, that is only man RAM is used. Now we'll put this code, not entire code, entire firmware, with the help of some commands like write command, read command, or status command. Okay, then we'll put some small part of program or any functional part of the program, put into the monitor program, and monitor program read by the CPU, and CPU will provide you the status of any RAM, ROM, resistor content, or any IO content with the help of your debugger. Okay, That is the main advantage of this monitor program. We can monitor it exactly going in the ROM and what exactly going in the CPU. Here we can modify also. We can go in single step. We can put your breakpoints also. That is the main advantage of monitor program also. It is one kind of combination of software simulation and hardware emulator also. Now come to the in-circuit emulator based firmware. Here nothing but with the help of hardware we can need to check your firmware. Okay. Ultimate target is debug the firmware. That we can do with the help of IDE software. You can use it. You can, whether it is vendor supplied or if it is vendor supplied IDE, then there's that IDE is specific to that target board. Like a Kyle like IDE, it is it supports n number of controllers. Okay. So debugging can be done on chip also and off chip also, but this is also supports IDE supports both in on chip also and off chip also. Okay. So this is the typical diagram shows that emulator we can use it. Nothing but this is emulator port, in circuit emulator. Okay. So it is one like a not exactly act like a target device. It is one replica of your target device. Okay. We can do connect it, we can modify changes, we customize it, but that we can do it on this. Now here the replica of target board which is in the IC, in circuit emulator. So no need to carry every time your target board, every time you have to check it, because target board, if number of limited number of target boards are there, it chances of get damage or that can be avoided here with the help of IC. Okay. Now you can do this in circuit in circuit emulation using the with the help of emulator system which contain some emulating device, memory, the logic controller or device which acts like your target devices. Okay. The device can be emulating device, can be your ARM 7 or any other target device, or memory it will emulate like RAM or ROM also, that also included. Even some logic controllers, logic controllers are also used. Control logic, we can implement it to trace any output pin or input pin, trace on it. Device adapters are connected to each pin, nothing but one pin to pin connection. We can analyze it whether input output of one pin is input to another pin. So we can analyze the reaching correctly or not, or whether it does that IC or circuitry can able to process it or not. Then on chip firmware debugging. The on chip firmware debugging again, main problem is that this part is more complex. We need to go in hardware layer, we need to think about in silicon level also sometimes. Okay. Now this on-chip debugging in case of firmware, we can use adopt like a breakpoint also, you can put, we can go in single step also. Then we can, this is basically used in on target board, what firmware able to want to generate signals that can able to that hardware generate or not. Okay. Because firmware developed on the simulator. The simulator acts, that software acts like a hardware. That can that mimic, that simulator mimic like a controller. But hardware does not mimic like a hardware is a real time. But really it generate able to that signal or not. That is on chip debugging is required. Now to debug the hardware, the various You can tools you can use it, as I discussed earlier, the magnifying glass, multimeter, CRO, logic analyzer, and function generators. Okay. So magnifying glass basically used to check the any crack in the PCB or any dry soldering or any component is missing or any misplace or wrong place of any component. That we can very closely we can analyze magnifying glass is required. Then multimeters to check the any proper voltage and current at each pin or each wire also. It's digital CRO are used to get the signals from each pin or wire or control signals or address or data bus that we can observe it on the screen also. Okay. Then logic analyzer basically go for hardware level now. The logic analyzer gives exact reflection what happening particular line of firmware is running. Okay. If that software is running, what exactly happening at each line of the firmware on that hardware target device also can be analyzed. Logic analyzer is used. Okay. It is one kind of CRO only. Okay. Function generator provide you the external signals. It can provide a sine wave, square wave, triangular waves, or any kind of waves where you can change the amplitude, frequency, or frequency. It's function generator. Boundary scan is nothing but related to each pin, how the exact signal generated by input pin that can reach to the output pin generated signal can be reached to the input pin of the any other IC. We can observe that here on PCB. In that IC, three ICs are there, IC 1, 2, 3 are there. Now you can observe that this is connected to our host machine. This is a clock, a TDI, what is meant by TDO. Now I'll come to the TCK now. Now here, TDI, test data input. So this is send the debugging command serially from remote debugger to the target port processor. Okay. Out is from target controller to the debugger. Then clock, TCK is clock, and TMS is for mode select, any testing mode you want or to reset. Okay. But our concentration on TDI, TDO and TCK. TDI is from host machine to the board, target board. TDO from target board to the that host machine. Now here three ICs are there, you can observe that the clock is common to all these IC. Okay, the line is, you can observe that this is, now we are boundary scanning with the help of nothing but output of each pin. We can scan it whether each IC can able to generate the required voltages or signals or frequency that we can observe it. Now TDI is from target host machine to the target. It send on signals, okay, and it should be acknowledged by that IC1 and they generate one output and send to the next IC, that is IC2. But this IC2 also generate one output and that is sent to the IC3. Nothing but the signal sent by the host machine reaching to the each IC or not, okay, through the connected physical path, or sometimes indirectly it can reach from one IC to another IC, it will reach it. Whether it reaching to properly or not, nothing but after reaching it, for example, in the first IC, after receiving the TDI from the host machine, the all these pins of IC will generate the required output voltage or not. That we can analyze it on the with the help of JTAG. Okay. So JTAG basically used to scan each boundary, nothing but each out a pin of the IC. That's why it's called boundary scanning. Okay. So this is all about the fifth module, where we discuss about various firmware and its debugging, hardware debugging, and the last part is the boundary scanning. Okay. Thank you.